Hello, and welcome to A Rainbow in the Clouds. I'm your host, Eleyne-Mari Sharp, a certified color therapist and founder of Aura House School of Color and Light. November is the month of Thanksgiving. Are you feeling grateful, or do you have a list of grievances a mile long? In this episode, I will talk about the palette of Thanksgiving, gratitude jars, and the blessings of the color gold. All that plus meditations and color breathing coming up next. Let's begin with a rainbow crystal grounding meditation. If you don't happen to have a crystal with you, please refer to the crystal image that you will find at rainbowpodcast.com. Okay, so let's take three deep breaths and call in your deities, your angels, and your spirit guides for love and protection. Now, pick up your clear quartz crystal and hold it in your left hand, which is the hand that you use to receive energy. And look closely at your quartz crystal. Notice all of its lines and cracks and chips and rainbows. Do you see the red? The orange? The yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. Now notice how you feel as you're holding the crystal. Are you feeling anxious, calm? Place your crystal on your heart and breathe in peace. Breathe out peace, feeling a wave of calm and comforting, beautiful white light containing all the colors of the rainbow. Now place your crystal on your heart and breathe in peace. Breathe out peace, feeling a calm and comforting wave of beautiful white light containing all the colors of the rainbow. Flowing through your heart and throughout your body. Breathe in peace. Breathe out peace. Breathe in peace. Breathe out peace. Now, move your quartz crystal down to your root chakra, which is located at the base of your spine. And imagine that there is a long red cord attached to your root chakra. And see that cord going down, down, down into the floor and into the ground, going deeper and deeper and deeper until you see that the cord is connected to a giant clear quartz crystal in the middle of the earth. Now think or say aloud, I am grounded with the courage of red. I am secure with red. So now that you're grounded, let's do some blue sky color breathing. Close your eyes and think of the clearest blue sky that you can imagine. A gorgeous, gorgeous blue color. And each time that you see a cloud, whether it's white or dark, think of this cloud as your thoughts, your anxiety, your grief, your anger. But don't dwell on the clouds. Just notice them. Just notice them as they slowly drift by. And as you imagine the sky in your mind, breathe in that brilliant sky blue. And breathe out the blue. Breathe in the blue. Breathe out the blue. Wherever you are and whenever you want to clear and calm your mind, remember this blue sky color breathing. It's a great tool and nobody knows you're using it. It's the end of November. And the leaves are still falling. Although I have lived through 60 plus autumns, I have to say that this natural process always saddens me because I know and I believe that the falling leaves are a metaphor for death. And I also know that winter is coming. Did you have a nice Thanksgiving? That's usually the first question that Americans ask their friends and their coworkers after the holiday. But what if you didn't have a nice Thanksgiving? What if your holiday was downright miserable? I read an article about starting a Thanksgiving tradition called a gratitude jar. And beginning November 1st, you're supposed to write down the things that you're most grateful for, and then store the paper in a jar of any type, and then share those thoughts with your family and friends during Thanksgiving dinner. Well, I'm guessing that the pilgrims didn't have a gratitude jar, but I wonder if they were really as reverent and as thankful as history has depicted. Or did they actually spend the entire meal complaining about all their miseries? Does this sound familiar to you? Sometimes family Thanksgivings, you know, are like that. But if the pilgrims did complain, I mean, seriously, who could blame them? Because it had been a long, hard year of back-breaking work in the fields, and there was cooking and cleaning and building and birthing babies, not to mention taking care of the sick and burying those who were either too ill or too old to survive. And the Thanksgiving meal, well, that had to have taken a lot of preparation time, since the entire harvest celebration lasted 3 days. Louise Hay says that the universe loves gratitude. And the more you're grateful for the good that is in your life, the more good you get to be grateful about. So I think about this. I am grateful for my life. I am grateful for my home. I am grateful for my husband. I am grateful for my kitties. I am grateful for my family. I am grateful for my friends. I am grateful that I have so many gifts that I often take for granted. I can read and I can write. I can walk most of the time. I can touch. I can see. And I'm also thankful that I don't have to cook that much food at Thanksgiving. And I'm thankful that I have a refrigerator, a stove, a dishwasher, a blender, and a food processor. And I'm sure the pilgrims didn't have those luxuries. Of course, I am also and absolutely grateful for the gift of color. Here in the United States, the traditional Thanksgiving meal resembles a food artist's color palette: a golden brown turkey with stuffing, white mashed potatoes with brown gravy, orange sweet potatoes, yellow corn, red cranberry sauce, green string beans, brown pumpkin pie topped with dollops of white whipped cream. While our Thanksgiving menu may differ depending upon our personal preferences or our culture, the color energies do remain the same. The wealth and wisdom of gold, the grounding and sensibility of brown, the cleanliness and purity of white, the joy and friendliness of orange, the confidence and knowledge of yellow, the passion and stability of red, the balance and renewal of green. Henry David Thoreau said, "I am grateful for what I am and have. My Thanksgiving is perpetual. No run on my bank can drain it, for my wealth is not possession, but enjoyment." Well, unlike Thoreau, some people believe that they can only be thankful if they are prosperous, if they're swimming in money. Does this sound like you? Do you get annoyed whenever you hear of someone getting a raise or winning a multi-million dollar lottery? Are you envious of your friends or your family or your coworkers, wondering when or if you too will finally have abundance, finally get to enjoy all the fruits of the golden horn of plenty? The color gold has long been revered as the symbol of infinite wisdom and affluence. But the blessings of gold is much more than obtaining material wealth, of having that Midas touch. Gold also represents an abundance of wisdom, of compassion, and of spiritual health. So let's experience the energies of the color gold now. Think of all the beauty that you associate with gold. It may be a gold coin, a gold necklace, a gold mirror, or some other gold object. Gold is the color of enlightenment, abundance, and wisdom. When gold is balanced, you feel wealthy, knowledgeable, and forgiving. When you do not have enough gold, you may feel distrustful, fearful, and envious. Now, close your eyes and imagine that you are sitting inside the ruins of a large stone temple in the middle of a Mayan jungle. There is no roof over the temple, and the hot sun is directly overhead. Allow the golden sunshine to fill the crown of your head. Breathe in gold. And as you inhale, breathe in wisdom and gratitude. As you exhale, breathe out envy and fear. Breathe in gold. Breathe out gold. Breathe in gold. Breathe out gold. Allow gold to flow throughout your body, from your head, down to your neck, to your chest, to your arms, to your stomach, and your legs, down to your feet. The affirmation for gold is, I am always grateful for the abundance of life. I am always grateful for the abundance of life. Now, imagine that you are no longer in the Mayan jungle, and instead, you are walking through a bright, moonlit path in the woods near a river, carrying a warm red blanket, a wooden flute, and a picnic basket. Your feet are crunching on golden leaves, and there are rabbits and squirrels scampering across your path. As you walk, you notice that the leaves are damper as you get closer to the water. Bend down and collect 12 of the moist leaves and place them inside your basket. You will use these later when you are ready for releasement. Soon, you are out of the woods and directly facing the rolling river, its dark water rushing over the smooth, large rocks. The full moon shines like a lunar spotlight on the gentle waves, and you are grateful for its comforting brilliance on this dark and cold night. Find a good spot and spread the blanket on the hard ground. Place the basket and the flute on one end of the blanket and be seated on the other. Open your basket and remove one golden leaf. Gold is the color of abundance, of wisdom. It is the horn of plenty. Think of a fear that you would like to release at this time. It may be a fear of failure, a fear of heights, a fear of change, a fear of death. No matter what the fear, you are releasing it today. As you think of your fear, lift the golden leaf above your head and announce, I release this fear to the river and to the universe. It is no longer mine to bear. I release this fear to the river and to the universe. It is no longer mine to bear. Then toss the leaf into the water and watch it and your fear float away. Do this with 5 more golden leaves until these fears too have floated away. When this is done, think of all the things that you may feel guilty about. Perhaps you feel guilty over something you said, something you did, or something that you did not do. You want to release these guilty feelings too. Remove a golden leaf from the basket and lift it high above your head and then say aloud, I release this guilt to the river and to the universe. It is no longer mine to bear. I release this guilt to the river and to the universe. It is no longer mine to bear. Toss this leaf into the water and watch it until it disappears from view. Remove the remaining 5 golden leaves from your basket and repeat this ritual until all of the leaves have disappeared down the river. Now, open the basket and remove your drinking cup and a loaf of hearty whole grain bread. Before you eat this meal of Thanksgiving, think of all the reasons that you have to be grateful. Be grateful for Mother Earth, for her trees and rivers and oceans and mountains. Be grateful for the moon and the stars, the night and the air. Be grateful for the fish in the waters, the birds in the skies, the plants, the minerals, the animals. Be grateful for your family, your friends, your employer, your employees, your coworkers, your teachers. All that exists have lessons to teach you, and you are grateful for their guidance. Now, dip your cup into the river, which flows with the goodness of clear, clean, drinkable water. Return to the blanket and bless your meal. With each mouthful of bread and each sip of water, you feel more grateful, more satisfied with your life. Overhead, the full moon appears to grow larger and larger as it pours its healing white light upon you. In gratitude, you pick up your flute and play a song of thanks to the heavens. You are grateful for your life. You are grateful for this day. All your fears, all your guilt have been removed from your being. Now, visualize that the river water is cleansed of all negativity, including yours. All is well. I'm Eleyne-Mari Sharp, and you have been listening to A Rainbow in the Clouds. As we close this episode, here is today's tip on how you can become a rainbow blessing in someone's cloud. Using the energy of green, you can encourage healthy living by showing them how to prepare a healthy meal. Or you can take them out into nature to enjoy the healing benefits of smelling a wildflower or hugging a tree. Some of the highlights from today's episode can be found in my book, Mad About Hue, A Memoir in Living Color, which is available on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, iBooks, and Kobo. If you felt inspired by this broadcast, be sure to visit rainbowpodcast.com to subscribe to the show, access the show notes, and register for my color therapy workshops. Until next time, no matter how you feel or where on the planet you live, don't forget to stop and enjoy the pretty colors.